What does it mean when the price is not disclosed to a property you're looking at online? I'm going to explain that to you today. Hi, I'm Tim Diesel and I'm a commercial real estate consultant. This channel is designed to give you tips and strategies to help your business grow. If you're a broker, this will definitely help your clients grow. All right, so let's not take up too much time on this video, but let's answer a question that came in. What happens when I'm looking at a property online and the price is not disclosed? Well, there's a couple things. Whenever it's a property of a lot of value, so let's say the property is $20, $30 million, whatever the case is, the seller and the broker decide that we're gonna see where the offers come in. So we're gonna let the market dictate the price, which is a good and a bad thing. The good thing is offers may come in higher. In a market like this where things are very competitive, hedge funds have a lot of cash, you never know, you might get an offer that's more than what you wanted. The bad thing is a lot of buyers will only try so hard to get a response. You gotta remember, whoever's marketing these properties, a lot of times, unfortunate truth about it is, maybe they don't answer the phone. Maybe it goes to voicemail and nobody checks the message till the next day. So they lose a lot of their patience, especially hedge funds or investment firms. They have an obligation to their investors and they need answers and they're looking all over the place. They can't get a hold of you to figure out your price. They're not very interested. Cap rate upon request, you'll see this. That's not very good, in my opinion. It works for some people, right? So I like the strategy of give you all the information and let you figure it out. So there's no sense of hiding the cap rate, because the truth is, once you're in contract, you can figure it all out. Why did you just waste everybody's time if you're really gonna do a 6 or a 7 and, you know, someone's expecting an 8? So that's kind of what I mean. You don't want to look at properties that are ambiguous. You want to be able to understand a lot of it. So a lot of the bigger properties say that, and that's okay. Just kind of, that's not really a market you'll probably find yourself playing in. A lot of the big commercial real estate firms, I don't particularly care for, but that's their tactic. They like to keep everything in-house and they like to get both sides of the deal. They have their own rinky-dink way of doing business. Don't let that stop you. You go out there and you find property and you talk to someone who will help you. So whatever their marketing package says, you can still get information. Even if it's a little bit of information, you can still get something. So you're just doing a little more legwork. But the truth is, they want you to make an offer and see what it's worth, and the seller will pretty much see if he'll accept it. A lot of times these sellers don't really want to sell, and the brokers will tell them, listen, I think we can get you an offer. And it's kind of a marketing ploy, and the effect of it is obviously generating phone calls, right? So every broker in the business, we like listings, right? We like to list property. Why? It generates business. People call on the property and we have more people to talk to. And this is not like a secret. Everybody knows this. Now, my strategies, I don't like to take on listings that aren't gonna move, because you're wasting everybody's time. Everyone's gonna be upset with you. The seller's not gonna like you very much, because you basically lied to them. You told them you can perform and you can't. So whenever I see anything that is not upfront, I tend to stay away. I take my clients somewhere else. But really, that's the only reason. That's the only reason it's disclosed, is to see if they can generate interest, because they're unsure. And the cap rate, they know exactly what the cap rate is if they had a price attached to it. So hopefully that helps you out. Let me also share with you, if you were to ask your customers or somebody who calls, maybe they didn't have to be your direct client, just kind of ask them, hey, how do you feel when a property is advertised and there isn't enough information on it? Well, it's very upsetting. So even when you were to look at some properties, sometimes you'll see an OM package and it's like 2 or 3 pages. And I mean, there's just not enough information. So you're trying to buy a $2 or $3 million property and you're having to call the seller and ask, hey, what's this? What's that? and you're wasting a lot of time. So be mindful of that if you're on the other side. If you're selling a property, what information would you ask for? Put all that up there. They're gonna find out. You want them to find out. You don't wanna sneak a deal by somebody. You want them to know, listen, this is good quality investment. This is what you're paying for. So be upfront as much as you can. I'm not saying to, if you honestly forget to add something, that's fine. That's one thing. But when you're creating your marketing package, make it so the other guy understands a lot more. So if you're getting questions all the time and it's what's this, what's that? Well, you'll know for the next time, hey, let's put this in there so I don't get so many phone calls and just inundated with questions that can easily be answered. I hope that was helpful. Like this video, subscribe to this channel, comment, ask me questions, send me your deals. I'll look at them gladly. And thank you guys so much for watching.